So the Legislative Blitz is 70 people coming to Washington, D.C. to do 168 meetings in 2 days, all here on the Capitol. As a constituent, anyone has the ability to come and talk to their representative or staff in the office of their representative. You just have to ask. And we do a lot of that for you. We help make the meetings, and then you show up and do all the talking. But you have a right to express yourself. It's the First Amendment.
My name is Debbie Cohen. I am involved in this because I am the Secretary-Treasurer of Explore Mars. I'm also a volunteer and member of the New Millennium Committee for Planetary Society. And I do this because I think that human exploration and robotic exploration of space is really important.
We are a group of 10 different nonprofit space advocacy organizations.
Tomorrow we are going to Congress and we're having meetings with approximately 168 congressional offices over 2 days. Well, we're all volunteers in this. I grew up with Apollo and I remember those days. It was a very exciting time and I've always been fascinated with the space program and I feel this is extremely important.
All the people that you're going to see are here because they feel passionately about it and for no other reason. You know, this isn't a vacation. You know, this is a lot of work. It's a lot of effort to walk around Congress all day, meeting office after office. Every person who's participating, I consider a true space advocate.
So is it worth the paper cuts?
I'll tell you at the end of it.
We've been having record cold temperatures for the last couple of weeks. This past week, we actually broke a 120-year low.
Okay, watch out, I might spray water.
It's very unusual for D.C. to have sub-zero temperatures.
Nope, I gotta go further.
The key is being a presence, and we want to make sure that there's always a Planetary Society opinion on any major piece of space legislation, that we're in the rooms when decisions are being made, so people realize that the Society is representing its 45,000 members as effectively as possible. A Planetary Society member is like a tip of an iceberg. For everyone who's so motivated to be a part of that organization, I think that they represent at least 10 other people who are interested but never took that leap. So we actually have a very nice crowd, I think, coming in. A lot of new faces, a lot of people we've seen before. So I'm excited, and I think we're going to have a lot of really great energy coming out of this. And so it's going to be a lot of fun.
Hi, this is your group assignments.
It's good to practice, and it's good to feel comfortable when you walk into that office for the first time, because it can be a little intimidating when you've never done it before.
We usually have approximately anywhere from 25 to 35 people. This year we had 70 people sign up. It's absolutely tremendous. And the more people we get, the more meetings we can support, and the more meaningful we can make this.
So everyone has a list in front of them of what group number they're in. Everyone has a group number. The group is going to be the people you're going to be going around with for the next couple days.
So I've never done anything political, but I'm interested in doing what I can, getting involved for Planetary Science.
I'm just here because I think science and space technology, it really benefits everybody.
I am an aerospace engineer by day and a volunteer space activist every other waking moment.
I'm really passionate about space and especially the commercial side of it.
I think they'll go pretty well. In my experience, the people that we meet with have always been willing to at least hear us out.
I'm really here today because I think science and space is one of those things that really brings us together as a country and moves us forward as a civilization.
I don't really know too much what to expect. I've walked around the Capitol as a tourist before. I think everybody's excited a little bit about space science in general, so I'm hopeful.
Everyone as a citizen can participate in the process of democracy, and it's far easier actually than most people think. So that's why we come. Congress depends on its constituents to tell its representatives what they need to know. Thanks for watching. If you want to learn more about this topic, check out the link in the description to this video. Otherwise, you can always go to planetary.org/spaceadvocate.